त्रोपरम ते चित्तम निरुद्धम योग सेवनात् यत्र चैवात्मनात्मानं पश्यन्नात्मनि तुष्यति सुखमात्यन्तिकं यत्तत् बुद्धिग्राह्यं मतीन्द्रियं वेति यत्र न चैवायं चितै चलति तत्तत्र यं लब्ध्वा चापरं लाभं मन्यते नाधिकं ततः यस्मिन् स्थितो न दुःखेन गुरुणापि विचाल्यते These are one more.
Yes. Tam vidya. Yes, one more.
Tam vidyat. Vidyat. Tam vidyat dukkha samyoga viyogam yoga sagitam sa nichayena yoktavyo yogo nirvin chetasam I show you how to note this down. You need pencil? Thank you. There, when he takes this vow, according to the direction of his master, that I have to do accordingly what I will feel that has been ordered within. After taking this vow perfectly, time comes yatra uparamite chittam niruttam chittam. His mind, sadhak's mind of sadhak takes the position of niruddha avastha. There are so many
stages
of one's mind. One is kept, first is kept. Second is vikept. Third is ekagra. Fourth is niruddha. Kept means when you think this is tape recorder, this is pencil, this is without any meaning what you are thinking.
Mind just moves from one thing to the next?
Yes. Without any purpose. Mm-hmm. This is book. What to you? Mm-hmm. This is pen. Mm-hmm. So you go on thinking like this. It is kept. Kept means scattered mind. This is the position of scattered mind. This has nothing to do with yoga. Yoga is actually away from this state of mind. This is the first state, ordinary state of life. Of a human being. What is this called? This is called kipt state. The second state is vikipt. Vikipt is, now when you want to control this, it goes away. You want to keep your mind one pointed. It goes away. It goes away at once. You want to keep on one pointed. This is the eyebrows. You put your consciousness and mind in eyebrows. It goes away to other object. Then it goes away to other object. And you collect awareness after some time. you don't collect awareness at that very moment.
Because you don't realize that your mind went away.
Went away, you are away, unaware. At that time you are unaware. And afterwards you think, oh, I was meditating, what have I done? I'm thinking of Ajmer or Go. That is the position of mind. It's called Vikhir. Then comes third state of mind, when you are bent upon putting it, you know, on one point in concentration. That is called Ekagra. Ekagra is one point. And you keep it one pointedness. It tries to go away. It tries to go away. Every now and then it tries to go away to some other object, to some other object. You have to be attentive in such a way that you don't let him go to, let that go to that object. You, before he goes to object, you drive him back to his own point. This is the state of mind which is called Ekagra. Then you have to go like this. This also has nothing to do with yoga. Samadhi is not possible in this way also. And afterwards, the state of mind comes in such a way that it becomes niruddha. It does not go away at all. If you drive it away, it won't go. It will go to one point. That is niruddha. That is when this mind has taken the position of niruddha, niruddha vasa. Niruddha vasa is one pointedness, automatic. Then you have not to drive him again back and back to return to his point. Returning ends at the ending stage of Ekagra. When Ekagra is finished, then you have not to try it again and again. That process is over. You have to watch them. How it is absorbed in one point. That is called niruddhavastha. And this niruddhavastha comes yoga sevana by continuity of practice, meditation. Then you have not to try it again.
It's automatic.
Huh? Automatic. Niruttam chittam. Yoga sevana by the practice of yoga. Niruttam chittam, when your mind becomes niruddha. Niruddha takes the position of your being one point for good. If you leave it open, leave this mind free, it won't go away. You have not to be watchful afterwards. Watchful ends at the ending point of Ekagra. You have not to be watchful after it takes the position of niruddha. At that time, you rest. You have not to be watchful. Niruddham yoga sevanat, by the practice of yoga, continuity of yoga, this mind then takes the position of niruddhavastha, yet uparamiti, where this mind automatically ceases to function. It does not function in the way it was going to do this function. Function going here and there. Yatra chaiva atmana atmanam pashyan atmani dushyati, and where Atmana Atmanam Pashyan. He realizes the nature of his own self-consciousness. And Atmani Tushyati. And he is satisfied with enjoying the bliss of self-consciousness at that time. Sukham Atyantikam Yatra. He experienced this Sukha. This is second shloka. At that time he experienced this Sukha. Sukha means joy. And which, what kind of joy? Authenticum. Authenticum, where there is no parallel. There is no parallel joy to it. That joy he experiences at that moment, when he realizes the nature of his own self at that moment. It is tremendous. Joy, the experience. And that joy is not seen by eyes, it is not felt by your organs. Buddhigrahyam. It is felt by your intellect only, internal intellect, super intellect. Patanjali describes this intellect as ritambara. It is filled with ritam means truth. It is true joy. It is not adjusted joy. Adjusted joy takes position in the contact of two. And this adjusted, this is not adjusted joy. It is automatic joy. So he feels automatic joy. Atindrayam, it is beyond the conduct, beyond the conduct of organs. Organs are not conducting this joy. Where this joy is felt, nachayavayam chidachalati tattatav, and when he is absolutely established in that joy, nachayavayam, then he does not move from that joy at all. There is another point to be watched and marked there at that time. Yamlabdha, when this joy is achieved, this automatic joy, aparam labham manyate nadikam, then he feels there is no another joy like this. In all the 118 words, this is the only joy which one has to possess and own.
Unparalleled,
yes. You can't imagine the fullness of that joy. Nadikam tada, he does not feel any other joy like this. Yasmin chito, when he is established once in that joy, nadukhena guruna pivacharite, even heaps of tortures come in front of him, heaps of pains. Come in his experience. Navicharite, he is not moved by those. He is not at all moved by those pains and sorrows and sadnesses of the world. This sadness of world, it comes to him, it appears as if it is in that joyous position. It is just like scratching a little bit, but that also is joy.
Like what?
Just scratching like this.
Asha.
No more. It is a fun, I think, afterwards. It becomes fun, it is not saddening.
Anything in this world.
Any torture, any pain, he feels just additional joy.
It's sugar-coated pain and torture.
Last shloka is in this connection. Tam vidya dukha samyoga Yogam, yoga sagyatam. You should understand, one should understand, the aspirant should understand that this joy which he is feeling within, and where with joy all pains and sorrows of the world if they come, if they are experienced, they enhance the beauty of that joy. They do not disturb that joy at all, clean. That joy you should consider. Vidya, you should think and you should know. Dukkha samyoga niyoga. It is the absence of all pain. No pain has guts to stand there. Tam vidya dukkha samyoga niyoga. And it is yoga sabhita. It is called yoga. Actually, it is yoga. It is the state of yoga. So nishchayena yoktavyo yogo nirjana chetasa. And that yoga should be contemplated and achieved by sadhaka with nirvana chetasa. It can be explained as anirvana chetasa and nirvana chetasa, both ways. Nirvana chetasa means with when he becomes totally absent from worldly pleasures. Not absent, actually not absent. He does not mean to leave them aside. He wants to find out the joy in those worldly pleasures also. Because he feels that joy is everywhere. Joy is in worldly pleasures also. That joy, that's super joy.
Nothing's to be excluded.
Yes.
Everything, not afraid
is in,
of anything.
Everything is included there. So you should try to experience that joy with not being bored to have it. And you taste the sweetest dish in the world. Go on tasting sweetest dishes, you'll be bored by that.
Yeah.
In time, if you're bored, you want to have some chutney afterwards.
Something sour.
But that does not take place in this experience of this joy. This is not boarding joy. You want to have it again and again. The same.
Nourishing.
Huh? Nourishing. Nourishing.
You crave after it. Is it? You crave, I mean, you never get enough.
But you never lose
it
also,
right? You want to have it again.
Listen, I mean, you never get enough.
No. Prashanta manasam yenam yoginam sukham uttamam upaiti shanta rajasam brahma bhutam akalbasham. Prashanta manasam. That yogi whose mind is prashant, whose mind is appeased from all sides. There is no need to worry about his mind, the position of mind. His mind is appeased. It has come to this perfect statement of being appeased. Yoginam, for that kind of yogi, sukham uttamam upaiti, prashanta manasam kenam yoginam. Yogi becomes object there. Yogi has not to find out the reality of God, the reality of nature of God. Yogi has not to find it. Nature of God has to find this yogi. That is what he says, prashanta manasam, yenam, it is object. He has to become object. Yogi has to become object for the joy. Joy has to go to him. Joy will find yogi. That yogi, joy wants to find out that yogi.
Which yogi?
Who has appeased mind. So joy is after finding out, searching, in search of that yogi. Yogi has not to search joy. That is Abhinavagupta's interpretation of that Bhagavad Gita verse.
So that means that yogi, what that means is yogi?
Yogi has to remain passive. And he's not active. He's not active. Joy is active.
So this is automatic. This is that point in sipping down where from then on, God carries you. You don't do any, nothing to do from your side.
No, there's nothing to do. No, don't worry about God. God has to worry about you at that moment. When your mind is appeased, then don't worry about it. God will find you. Because God is in search of you. God will be subjective and you will remain object, passive. Action is to be taken by God. You have not to take any action. Remain as you are. Don't worry about it. It is his headache to find. That's what he says in this shloka. Prashant manasam henam yoginam sukham uttamam upaiti shantarajasam. He says shantarajasam, where all the activity of the world is at peace. Brahmaputam, he is absolutely one with God. He has become one with God. Why should he worry about God? God has to search him. Akalmashan is without any kalmash. Kalmash means no dirt. Without dirt, he is absolutely clean. He has clean mind. He has without, he has no dirt in his nature.
You mean no malas?
No malas. Then God is bent upon finding him. He is remaining, lying on soap.
Just wait.
Yes. Why should he wait?
I'm not even waiting.
It is his
headache. Yeah, he's fine already. He's appeased. Yeah.
Yinjanevam sadatmanam yogi niyatamahanasa sukhena brahma samyogam atyantam adigacchati. They have spoiled this moment. Yinjanevam sadatmanam yogi niyatamahanasa sukhena brahma samyogam atyantam adigacchati. Yinjanevam sadatmanam. This way you should contemplate always. Yogi should contemplate this way, netamanasa, and keeping his mind absolutely under control. Full control. Full control means that niruddhavasa. Then he keeps quiet. He does not move. If you are away also, if you are not attending your mind, mind has no guts to move. It won't move. It is a beast. This way yogi should act. Sukhena. He has not to put effort to realize this position of God. Yeah. Sukhena. Playfully. Brahma samyogam atyantam. He becomes one with Supreme God Consciousness. Playfully. Without doing any effort. He appeases, attains the state of God Consciousness for all times.